Everyone to this FPGA live stream. Here, as per the previous video, Piotr Esten from 1bit² sent this amazing open source icebreaker FPGA over that we unboxed and took a quick look there on the previous live stream with the Lattice ICE5K logic element. FPGA field programmable gate array, and the previous live stream also we had to package, well, we first need to get our toolchain going, because for programming field programmable gate array we need something an equivalent of a compiler like GCC or Clang that Clifford Wolf and others have reverse engineered, because up until some years ago you needed the proprietary, usually Windows, and in any case large, expensive and buggy FPGA synthesis tools, and only the latest years now with Yosys and surrounding FPGA synthesis suite software it is possible now to do this with open source tools, and we have not yet packaged all of them. So this is why this field is still relatively new and certainly interesting. So you at home probably want to use something like either your distribution packages, or if your distribution packages do not ship Yosys and NextPNR and iVerilog and all the other fun stuff, then you can use Esten's Summon FPGA tool script here that is building this here in some shell script. We have done this the last day, so I packaged all of them. I just finished like literally this morning, well, finished and finished, not yet 100%, but we added a couple of packages here to T2, which our open source rolling stuff. So if you want a science programmable something, Linux distributions, maybe T2 is for you. So Yosys, also I packaged this the other day, updated this a little bit. iStorm, libftdi, OpenCD, and iVerilog updated. So we even had this. So even literally I packaged this a decade ago, so much to our not amazing one-man distribution stuff and another stuff. So I also added other packages like Euler and Euler, similar stuff like this. Also had to update Boost, because anyway, so there you see how you spend your days with this. Anyway, so you have this all now in T2 or with Esten Summon FPGA tools. And what we want to do some Hello World stuff, obviously, to have here some blinking lights on this. And for this, we first need to understand how this works internally. So internally, this field programmable gate arrays that were invented somewhere, I think mostly in the 80s, consists of what? Fast Pixies got angry at time. Anyway, so this works internally with this field programmable gate arrays consist of logic blocks, and you would think this 5k logic elements or logic blocks does not sound like much. However, I said already in the initial video that it is enough to implement Clifford Wolf's PicoRISC-V 32-bit microcontroller kind of processor here. And this works by 5000 logic elements is not equivalent to 5000 logic gates, because if you take a look here on this simplified from straight from Wikipedia, so this each of those logic cells, usually again simplified, but consists of some lookup tables, some LUTs, and like here for in this example, four input LUT, full adder, a D-type flip-flop as shown to the right, and also potentially some combined into some MUX and arithmetic mode and outputs and so on, and then of course all the fabric interconnects to flexible route what input and output go wherever. And this is what this open toolchain is doing, like Yosys, what people had to first reverse engineer, because reverse engineering 2019. And now that this is freed, what I've done to give this a try, and maybe let me move the camera around 1 second. Just a little bit cut transition there to save those archived on-demand videos, a little bit of some camera movement there. So if you plug this in, it looks like so we can plug this in. So again, this icebreaker, I hope, by the way, we are streaming. Let's maybe double check that stream health, stream is healthy, hopefully. And so again, as per previous video, this is the FPGA, the programmable gate array, and some USB controller here for flashing, also for the EEPROM to load your program. And when I plugged this in, this was already programmed. So this is at least how it shipped to me. And so this is already coming with some Hello World program, as you can see, and blinking here some LEDs. And to show you how this is programmed and done, let's take a closer look here. Now that we packaged all of those tools, the open source community around this project has done a nice job to provide you quite some Hello World examples that you can also clone here straight from GitHub. Icebreaker FPGA examples, I've cloned this here. Also, comments in the audience, benefits of FPGA. Welcome everyone. So the benefit is it's not a processor, right? So on a regular processor, you would have some fixed speed, especially low power and small ones, like 16 megahertz or whatever. And a processor is always processing all this, the program, in a serial fashion. And what an FPGA is doing is that you can program all these logic elements, all these 5,000 plus, not gates, but logic elements, in an individual fashion. So for example, all of this stuff is running in parallel. So you could have just some inputs and outputs, just some combinatorial logic, and ending and ORing stuff together. So this is like quite instantaneous. So if you you do not need to program a processor on it. So it's not a processor, it's just 5,000 logic elements. And the benefit is it's like quite instantaneous. If you have some real-time stuff, some sensors, some all this kind of stuff, it's not like you need an interrupt and your process executing and jumping from somewhere, or can get stuck and crashing and so on. So this is one benefit. Another benefit is that all the stuff, so for example, you could implement USB or serial or some display controller and all this fun stuff, and it's all running in parallel. So you could have some 1,000 logic elements doing your USB input, with some other 1,000 logic elements doing some display output, and all of this because it's not a processor. It's like 5,000 in this case anyway. Of course, there are also smaller and larger FPGAs. Thousands of flexible programmable logic elements. And because they are flexible programmable, you could implement yourself or take examples here from the open source community. You could implement a own processor. So you could use, like in the case of Pico RISC-V, you do not need to wait for some manufacturer in Taiwan or China or somewhere else to implement a RISC-V processor for you. Open source people or yourself can do this. And this is why in this 5,000 logic elements, you can upload your own RISC-V or even Spark or ARM or even I said the other lifetime. Theoretically, nobody is stopping you to implement your own 8086. Certainly, I guess this, I would estimate this 5,000 logic elements are not enough to implement a 386 with memory management unit anyway, I guess. But I don't want to stop you if you want to try this. But certainly, I said in the initial live stream, so not only can you, you can program this 5,000 gates to re-implement a Commodore 64 or Aston set, even a Nintendo Entertainment System, and have this run in hardware and without the limitations of a fixed function processor. And so much to the benefits. Code ASM writes mostly parallel. If you route some stuff to other parts, there might be some delay. Yeah. So, of course, all of those 5,000 logic elements, they are all in parallel, but you get some clock delay if you use some hundreds of those, or usually not hundreds, all of them run in parallel plus whatever you chain them to implement logic functions like a processor, arithmetic logic unit, or pipeline, or all the other stuff. Indeed, this is also the synthesis speed. So how this is programmed, we can take a look on the 7-segment counter. By experimentation, I realized what is, I think what is loaded here. So maybe Piotr wants to comment there if he sees this live stream earlier. It looks to me like the example program, maybe they use for unit testing to check that they validate that everything they send out is working and not dead on arrival, is maybe blink count shift, I think. Blink count shift. So I can show you this, so we can take a look in this example that you've seen, that blinking these LEDs should be this one. And let me just check what we have on the screen here for your viewing pleasure. So this is how it looks to program this this FPGA. So this is, of course, looking similar to C or something like that, but just, well, similar but different, as you see, because of the nature of describing those logic operations. So defining some module, defining some inputs and like clock, LEDs, outputs. This is just defining some names to have a little bit more readable source code here, and not like pin something, but giving this some nice names. And so here's some bits. They define your local parameter bits equals 5, some logic delay and some registers. So bits, probably getting into really programming this probably for another live stream. So always for an edge on the clock begin and assign your counter, like incrementing the counter, assign your counter to counter plus 1, and out count counter shifted by this delay, log delay. So this is 22 times shifted to the right, and assigning here the outputs to the out count here being what we have the counter shifted rightwards. You see it is somewhat similar kind of to C, in my opinion anyway, just to give you some a little bit. But you also see this is fully parallel. It's not like some function. So this is basically for each clock input assigning this and assigning the output here to whatever temporary parameters, local parameters we have defined here. Let's see what comments we have in the audience. Christian looked at something for a while, no idea what they want to do forward. Special AI oscillator, wonder if A is using FPGAs on a syntactic brain. So you could certainly implement AI like features on an FPGA usually. So this is of course a smaller one, an entry level one. Certainly you want more than 5,000 logic gates, but AI for example, but of course this is also used for all kinds of motor, server controls, robots, even I said this. So not only, I mentioned this in the previous video, even this commercial frame grabber here, which again I can't recommend because binary only driver nonsense. So even this frame grabber here with VGA, DVI stuff, even this is using internally a, I think, Spartan or something, FPGA and even document scanner. So I know some document scanners, not all, but some esoteric models come with an FPGA actually. So it's used whenever you have a lot of logic processing stuff and either a processor is not enough or a processor like a CPU is too expensive, or you anyway need other logic surrounding this. And for example, you could do, of course, very high speed. What would take millions of cycles on a programmable CPU could potentially be done in real time with much less logic gates. And again, you can, and we will do this in another video, not today, but another video, we will load here, we will synthesize and load the Pico RISC-V in here and then have our own flexible RISC-V processor inside of FPGA, but that is for another video. And you still have quite some thousand logic gates left to do other stuff. So as Aston said, you can load a whole Nintendo Entertainment System on here, and what my idea was, or others, you could do your own computing platform with a RISC-V CPU and still have gates left for audio and video and potentially audio sound, like some FM synthesis and other videos. Because, for example, we have here one module we have here with DVI output, so you could create your own computing system if you wanted to, for gaming and whatever, video processing, audio processing. Anyway, so this is how the program looks, not too unfamiliar to see, just like entirely different anyway. And as this, so how does it work internally? To synthesize this, so normally you would use GCC or CLang for and assembler and linker, like GNU binutils or the LLVM linker and assembler. And you would compile C to object code and have this object code given to the assembler usually, and assembled to machine object code, and then usually linked together, like multiple object files linked together by the linker, and finally outputting the machine code directly that can be run on a CPU. And here we can take a look in this makefile. So this makefile is not doing much because it's just defining what device to use and then including the main make function, which we then can take a look in here. And here we will see what stuff is done. So this is using Yosys, this Clifford Wolf's open source synthesis software. So this is doing all the heavy work of generating, so synthesizing the logic element configuration to a bitstream, and also using here either Aragne PNR or Next PNR for the pick and root to root all the logic gate configuration in whatever you can imagine. If you have a RISC-V processor with quite some thousands of logic definitions, that takes some time to compile this to the root of logic elements, combining them and routing them. Also, you cannot straightforward just generate this, because certainly this is a relatively large problem space, and also this needs to be routed quite efficiently, as probably CodeASM pointed out. This is not fully parallel, because in combinatorial logic, for a more sophisticated algorithms, you have quite some logic elements outputs going to other inputs. So the speed that you can run this on depends on how this is combined and routed. And this is what this is doing internally. So we can go here to the 7th segment, for example, that you see this, because right now this blink count and shift is loaded onto there. And so let's take something else, which could be here the 7-segmenting, so 7-segment count. And let's see, do we even show this? Maybe mostly. And let's see if make clean works, because I've run this already. Let's see if make clean, okay, this is even doing something amazing stuff. So even for the small example, now this is a Ryzen, as you see, not using the Shabby Mac Mini today. So what has it done here? Obviously quite a bit. And this is synthesizing the design, so importing modules here, Yosys. So it's using running Yosys to synthesize this design. Next PNR to root, pick and place here the logic cells for all the synthesized design. Quite some information, so constraints, what we defined here in this example, packaging logic units. So let's see, packaging, so 12, apparently 12 logic, what is logic, LC was logic, so some people call it logic element, or often this is the same. So LC FPGA, that is logic, logic cells. So some people call it logic cells, other people call it logic elements. So 12 logic cells used as slot 4, 50 logic cells used as slot 4 and DFF, and packaging non-LUTs, packaging carries, packaging RAMs, PLLs, and so on. Device utilization, so after pick and place and routing everything, this here is synthesized as a target frequency of 12 megahertz, and the utilization is of course here very minimal, only like 1%, like you see of all the other stuff that is included in this particular FPGA is here 0%, because I mean certainly it's a super small example, just the most minimal hello world certainly, and here some 9 cells here certainly, and some 68 cells, creating initial placement for remaining 68 cells. Do we really use 68? Maybe does this add up to 60, actually 50, 62, yeah, something of that sort. Apparently 68 cells may be used according to this output of the 5000 that we have, but again, this according to the documentation of other examples surrounding PicoRISC-V, PicoRISC-V probably consumes something of 700 to 1000 or something logic elements or logic cells on this ICE40, depending on what feature set you choose from PicoRISC-V, as you can flexible configure this. So we have not yet loaded this here onto the FPGA. So if we plug this in here again, this will also best not to short say something. So this will still run the previous example because that is loaded and flashed into the EEPROM. And we can program this now with ICE program. And so this is our 7 segment count bin. So as you see, this indeed here works. This is flashing now, and now it's ready again. Flash ID, file size, erase 64K, programming, reading, verifying, done. And now you see this is not running our blinking example that it came with. Even if we plug it out and plug it in again, we have reconfigured the FPGA bitstream configuration there that is now stored, which by the way, do we also autofocus this? And so of course not the most amazing example, it is just in hello world to give you an overview how the steps look. And we can this, I think this example should output this to the 7 segment example, which we still would need to solder the pin headers on. I just wanted to show you the hello world example here without having soldered or something. Also, this is done very cleverly here with this breakout pad, so that here on this small bridges we indeed have some PCB traces, which we also could focus theoretically check. So really clever PCB design, really like this. That there would be, by the way, something to point, so that there on this breaking the bridges there on the PCB, we have actual traces there going to the buttons and LEDs. So as long as you don't break this off, you still have this as one PCB. And then if you are done with your first test and whatsoever, want to do something more, then you can break it off and solder the additional stuff here on the PMOD headers for the 7 segment and other fun stuff. If we want to change this again here to the original programming, we can go to, that was blinking something. Yeah, also not as root, blinking count something. Again, if we, I've compiled this here already because certainly before the video I wanted to test if it really works. We can synthesize this again and get a similar output. So this is synthesized to, let's take a closer look. This is using, you also see max delay here, 11. So max frequency for clock, this is max frequency of 76 megahertz, passes at 13 megahertz. this is exactly this propagation delay of combined logic units or logic cells, and maximum delay here 11 something nanoseconds. And here for this design, we again target frequency might have been, is this defined in icebreaker example? Let's go back to blink count and shift. What is defined here in this example? Is this maybe or whatever? Maybe this is in the make file. Actually, let's take a look in the make file. Yeah, frequency 13. There, this is coming from there. And so this example using similar amount of cells just for the input and outputs and a little bit shifting and adding stuff together. And let's program that. Oops. Not 7 segment, but this was this original blink and stuff bin. So IceProc. So these tools are all from the open source tools surrounding Yosys, IceStorm, and so on. And now we have our original verification factory target here. Apparently, just this bit shifting there, outputting. So with this clock, just added up and shifted down, and there's the LEDs blinking in that pattern. That's that for the first initial look here. Status update and initial how-to, how does it work? Of course, we can now modify this. Certainly implementing a full NES or your own vintage, or well, actually not vintage, if you actually are defining your own Pico RISC-V project with your own VGA output, then that would of course not be vintage or retro, that would be latest state of the art then, of course. And just to give you an overview how this works internally, so not unlike programming in C or assembler, something of that sort, and now with this open source tool, certainly so much more amazing than commercial binary only programs for Windows. Let's see, quite some comments there since we have given you this overview. Seen a special, okay, we have seen this FPGA DSP, looking into FPGA, so old school DSP, audio processing a DSP we also have here. Probably can also make a video about this with our vintage ISA card, this Motorola DSP 56K. Been there, done that 20 years ago. Now, in circuit self-reprogramming, it's possible to suggest first to get understanding through AI coding first. Not there yet. So, you do not need to in-circuit program for AI. Is a classic neural network stuff. You probably can run neural network stuff. So you could either pre-train the network and use this logic cells as your neurons and have your artificial intelligence pre-trained and flashed on there. So you could train a neural network to recognize cats or so, attach your camera here and have it run without reconfiguration, just the logic cells forming your neural network and just running on the camera input there. No reprogramming necessary. Reprogramming would only be necessary if you actually want the stuff to be self-learning like a Terminator and relearn while it's running and doing stuff with cats, and you get the idea. And partial reconfiguration is currently being hacked in for Xilinx devices in next PNR project X-Ray. And Christian Mini PCIe board sets an ARM Cortex and an FPGA. Should be pretty good for analog circuits. So this depends. So some FPGAs have analog logic, well, analog elements, but not all of them. So maybe this doesn't have any analog input. So if you are working with analog input, then you would need to have analog to digital converters, ADCs, that I'm probably pretty sure that some FPGAs most likely come with ADC input modules, and ADC to Navarro writes ADC is just a bunch of resistors and comparators here. So this is old-fashioned parallel ADCs could have been done with resistors, but the quality is not the most amazing. New Sigma Delta ADC and digital to analog decks do not use resistors anymore and rather have some Sigma Delta ADC converter stuff. And redirected analog pins not doing any processing to them. So this is not forwarding analog signals. So if you cannot like redirecting analog pins in this form, most likely because they are a logic level. So this would be plus zero, like ground to VCC, whatever. 1.3235 volts that would be. Current day FPGAs run very low voltage, so even input and output are on 1.2 volt ranges. Logic inside might even corrupt your signal. Yeah, and again, creating your own controller with LVDS panels seem like fun project. Yeah, so you could implement your own HDMI or DVI logic. But this would consume quite some logic gates. This is why here is an HDMI PMOD. So we could actually do this next. Oops, there's also first thing here on the floor. So this is a HDMI PMOD that I showed already. That is an optional feature to that. And what this allows you is to save, because if you would implement HDMI yourself, which you probably maybe nearly could here in logic cells of the FPGA, that would of course consume quite some thousands of them. So using a pre-built HDMI transmitter like this one or any other allows you to reuse this ready-made logic for that, just like on a old-fashioned graphic card. And can we also zoom that? Hopefully, maybe, apparently, allegedly. And we can do this. So this is also what I will most likely do. I'm not sure how much time I will find. I only wanted to provide in getting started hello world and that the stuff is packaged in T2 and working. And so this connects to some of those PMOD headers there that we would still need to solder. Also there, so you need to solder that there. And ground 5 volt there. We will do this sometime soon, maybe in an hour or two on the More Life channel. So if you're up to More Life stuff. So this plugs in then like that, and that is a fixed function HDMI logic in there. And with this you could implement a project with a Pico RISC V. This was for sure what we will do next. Well, next we'll be testing the 7 segment soldering. There's some headers because soldering, and then certainly testing all of this. And then in another week or two, synthesizing here this Pico RISC V and adding there maybe some HDMI output and other fun stuff. So if you are into any of this, don't forget to share, like, and subscribe also on the secondary More Random Life channel, because that is where we will do all the soldering and testing and all the more long hanging around here and chatting together kind of stuff. And let's see, what else do we have in the comments? Quite some. So creating your own controller for LDF seems like a fun project. You think Arduino board could handle LVDS might be interesting. I have a dedicated Chinese board for HDMI to LVDS, but making their own scaler is more fun. So what we will... So all of this other stuff, of course, these examples are... You can just take them and run them, and that is what I wanted to show you here today. Also that this is working. And in the T2 and where to get this Summon FPGA toolchain, or of course your distribution at hand, and where to get the examples and how to make and ICE program them. All the other stuff will take longer, because then even if you take pre-ready-made open source modules like the Pico RISC V and the FPGA driver, then stuff becomes more complex and you need to debug this, and debugging this for sure will be a lot of fun. something of that sort. And so even there are example projects for that under the term Pico RV32 SOC. So that's here something of maybe that sort. And what this Pico SOC is already the Pico RV32 RISC-V ISA core, plus here some additional UARTs and stuff that you have some communication, and then you can still add your own logic, like what you want to do with this, sensors, GPIOs, ADC, the HDMI, PMOD and other fun stuff. So as soon as we get into this territory, easily we can spend a day or two or weekend on just writing the code, combining these modules and trying to compile the synthesizers, and certainly lots of fun. And let's see, what else do we have there? Possible need transmitter IC to get the correct signal levels. So we need level converters, speed 2, both maybe. Pre-trained cells on that also possibility. Implement TMDS for HDMI, it's a pain. So, but yeah, is had to allow you. Yeah, this is also why I made some people admin, because really tired of approving all the messages myself. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this. Next, if you are into total random live streams, leave me the comments below if you want to see all the random stuff, including soldering all those headers on there, and then testing the LVDS transmitter. And yeah, that's coming next. Hope you learned something and inspire you to do your open source fun. I'm a little bit tempted, actually. So what you can also do is certainly add your own logic. For example, right now you can't connect a keyboard, although you have serial here. And theoretically, you could also implement PS2 here on some headers with some other glue logic, obviously some resistors and transistors, and have your keyboard and mouse input. And I'm a little bit tempted to maybe, like similar to the 8-bit guy, it would be cool to have here some kind of computing personal gaming system, like 8-bit graphics or whatnot. This, for example, this is HDMI PMOD, PS2 keyboard and mouse or something, and some storage. And theoretically, it might be even, at least today, cheaper and more affordable. But leave me in the comments below what you think. Do you want to see all the soldering? And what would, if you maybe get one and get into FPGAs, because certainly totally interesting field to work in, what would be your idea? What would you want to do, or what would you want to see here? And what do you think about this kind of projects? Maybe some fun vintage retro gaming here on modern RISC-V. Navarro writes, $10 you get running with display and PS2 keyboard. That running with display, and you mean this with this display? This, you mean this display and a PS2 resistor and stuff. Yeah, thanks for watching. Hope you learned something. Hope that gives you some overview. The tools are, of course, all in T2, and let's reload this. This is only updated 2 times. So what you need for this arc, this is maybe just so. Everything you need for this is Yosys, NextP and R, then here's some dependencies, and also I think I didn't use iVerilog, but iStorm you need. So you need, as far as I've seen, you need iStorm and its dependencies like libftdi, NextP and R, and Yosys, and then this kind of FPGA starter kit, and you're good to go to get into FPGA programming. Also, I think I've not shown this right. So here's so much to Yosys, iStorm. Here you have it. Hope you learned something, and to see you soon for the next videos and live streams to come.